How's it going, everyone? So in this video, we are doing another keyboard unboxing and first impression. And this is a mechanical keyboard made by Logitech. The model number is K845ch. The CH stands for the Cherry MX keys that's being used on this keyboard. The K845 actually features a few different versions. The one without CH uses a generic mechanical key, which I wouldn't recommend. I would always recommend Cherry MX based keyboards because they are just a much more reliable, very tried and true keyboard mechanical switches that I've been using for years, and none have failed so far. Okay, so this is the Cherry MX Blue keys. And the keyboard in front you see is my personal keyboard, which is a desk keyboard, 10 keyless. This one uses the Cherry MX Brown keys. Now, if you guys are interested in mechanical keyboards, before this one, I did another keyboard review, actually more than one keyboard review, of the CD108. That keyboard, in my opinion, is the best keyboard under $100 because it features full Cherry MX keys. It's a full size. And it sells for around $80. And that's probably the cheapest Cherry MX keyboard I can find on Amazon, okay, or anywhere else. So definitely check that review out. There should be a link on the top. So let's get started unboxing this one. So this has been previously opened. And the reason I'm doing this review is because I lost all my video footage for the unboxing of this keyboard. So I'm doing another unboxing and first impression just to show you guys what this keyboard is about. Okay, so opening up the box, this is what you would expect in the box, very plain packaging. And you have pretty much just a warranty manual over here. And this is all you get, okay, in the original box. There might be a plastic cover, but I have thrown that plastic cover away, but that's pretty much it. That's all you get. A eco-friendly packaging nonetheless, so that's pretty good. Now, the design of this keyboard is more geared towards office use and pretty similar to the purpose of the desk keyboard. It's an office keyboard, but I use it for office and gaming, of course. I mean, with a particular key, you can definitely use any kind of so-called office keyboard for gaming, and you can also use gaming keyboard for office use, okay? Very interchangeable. This one features a LED light. It's white illuminated LED light. So if you guys are thinking about, you know, using your custom PBT, like double casting keycaps, you can. This keycap, let's check it out. This seems to be a double casted keycap, okay? So it's got, usually, you know, because it's got two different colored of plastic injection molding in there. So it's got a clear one and it's got a solid, like a kind of gray colored one. In terms of the keycap thickness, it's kind of like middle of the road. It's not super thin, but again, it's not super thick. They're doing this because, again, they're trying to make a putting key looking keyboard because it's actually got a MX LED lighting under there. And you can see the keyboard switch itself is actually clear. That probably signifies there is a LED light under it. So in terms of usability, yeah, it's pretty nice. You can use it in the dark. Not like my current keyboard right here doesn't have any illumination on there. And the Cherry Brown key under there is solid black color. There's no clear color surrounding the switch, and that's a difference, okay? So also interesting for this keyboard, the panel, the top panel is actually aluminum, okay? Solid piece of aluminum. And the aluminum actually sits on the bottom of the switches, as you can see. On my desk keyboard, the aluminum piece actually is surrounding the bottom one, the bottom PCB board. The design are different, but in terms of usability, there really isn't much difference. I would think this one is actually a little bit easier to clean compared to the other one. The other one, if I need to clean it, I have to pull all the keycaps out. I have to use a vacuum to like kind of vacuum all the hairs. I have lots of cats, so cat hairs, and then blow it out. And sometimes I flip it over and I unscrew all the screws and I take the top cover off and then do a deeper clean. But this one, it just seems like it's much easier to clean. All you have to do, like if you pull the keycaps off, you can see the aluminum piece actually surrounds the key very tightly, okay? So in terms of like ease of cleaning, I would say the K845 definitely wins in that category. You guys can hear that signature Cherry MX Blue click. It's beautiful sounding. Now I know a lot of people just cannot handle this click. And for that reason, you're much better off going with a red key or a brown key for that matter, because those keys are much, much quieter. It doesn't make any noise. And it's a good compromise between gaming and typing. But if you want the ultimate typing experience, you definitely want a Cherry MX Blue key, okay? Yeah, in terms of construction quality, that's not very heavy. So I don't know, like it's a full size keyboard, but it's not even as heavy as my dad's tin keyless keyboard. Again, I believe there are some sort of cost cutting, you know, measures being implemented, but I haven't told you guys the price of this keyboard yet. This one with Cherry MX Blue keys on sale for $59.95. on Amazon. I got it when it was on sale. Now I think the price kind of jumps around a little bit. Right now the price is around $69 or $79, but you should definitely get it if it's on sale for less than $60, okay? It's a no-brainer. Ultimate typing experience with blue keys if you don't mind the noise. So the next section, let's actually take a look at the back, okay? Also, one thing that's kind of nice is it's got a nice kickstand over here. However, it's only got one level adjustment. Some of the other keys, like the other keyboard that I reviewed, the CD108 full-size keyboard, actually has two levels of height adjustment. So in terms of adjustability, again, cost-cutting measure right here from Logitech. You got lots of rubber paddings right here to ensure the keyboard doesn't really move around during actual use. Excuse my cat. He needs attention, but the cable length, I believe it's about 6 foot. So plenty long if you actually need to have it reach your PC somewhere hiding under the desk, you can definitely do that. There are some multifunctional keys over here on the top. So this one is to adjust the actual LED lighting on the keyboard. It's not to adjust the screen brightness, okay? So keep that in mind. Those keys, you press the function and you press those two, it's gonna adjust the lighting on the keyboard. There's a magnifying function. There's a really nice that Logitech actually included a calculator function key. Really convenient to pull up calculator from anywhere. I really love this feature. And also you just gotta have volume controls right here, which is within, you know, within reach. I really love when people actually put the most important function keys where they are. Now, if you press function, you press this, you can mute it and you can adjust the volume up and down, like really conveniently. On desk keyboard, they didn't put too much thought on it. So they actually put the volume key over there, which is kind of dumb, like the dumbest thing ever. I have to press function key and use the other hand to control the volumes, which is not nice. And again, kudos to Logitech for including a lot of useful function keys on this keyboard. And you have the media keys from F5, F8. That's also nice. Print screen, screen lock. And I don't even know if anybody uses this key anymore, maybe in certain situations. But and you can also notice that the page up, page down, and all those keys are actually just within two letters. HM means home. Like they're trying to cut corners on printing cost. I don't know. This is page up and page down. So I'm gonna plug the keyboard in and we're just gonna take a look when the LEDs turn on and we're gonna do some typing test, let you guys see how well this keyboard performs and what it sounds like. All right, I just plugged the keyboard in. As you can see, it's actually a very, very beautiful keyboard, especially with that aluminum diffused lighting. It's actually quite beautiful, okay? And exceptionally usable, especially in a dark situation. Look at my desk keyboard, doesn't have anything, and it's super dark. For people that needs this illumination, I think that helps quite a lot. And for people that loves to experiment with their keycaps, if you put a PBT, like a putting keyboard on top of the putting keycaps, it's gonna look very, very nice. It's gonna have that diffused look. Actually, I have a few keys. I'm gonna switch it out for you guys. All right, this is two last, I guess, putting keyboard that the keycaps that I have left. I'm actually just gonna switch those out for you guys to see what it looks like, okay? So I think that's a function key. So if you use a diffused keycap right here, it's gonna look nice, okay? And let's see what the general effect. And also take note that there's only one Windows key over here on the left side. Over here, you only have a function key and a right click key right here, okay? But again, I'm just using those keycaps for you to take a reference. What the keycaps looks like if you use a half translucent keycap. Now those are Cherry MX keys, so you have a lot of options when it comes to customizing the top. You can do whatever you like. Just keep in mind that the LED is white, so it's not color LED, but again, a white LED is more functional and more useful than anything else. So I'm gonna put those keys back. But yeah, you have lots of customization options. Now also, worth noticing is that the Logitech, this is not their gaming keyboard, so those Alt and Control keys are actually standard sized Control keys and Alt keys, which is great news. Like, if you use this for gaming and you want custom keyboard keycaps, you can use custom keycaps and probably replace almost everything on here. The only thing you need to take note is probably just you have to be careful of the key spacing. Let's see, of the key spacing on the shift keys and maybe the enter keys, because sometimes they are not standard sized. Let's see. All right, so let's take a look. So sometimes the keys are not standardized, but not this one. Let's see the enter key. Let's see if it's standardized. Oh, so, all right. The good news for this keyboard is every key on here is standard Cherry MX compatible, Cherry MX keycaps compatible, okay? Including the enter key and the shift key. They all have the exact same spacing underneath, as you guys can see. Okay, same spacing. All right, so that's really, really nice. Okay, if you need to customize it, if you need to put different colored keycaps on it, feel free to explore and play around. Yeah, now let's actually just go into the typing section. I mean, after all, that's the most important part of this keyboard is the Cherry MX Blue typing experience. All right, so we'll do a quick typing test using the Logitech K845 Cherry MX Blue keys. Keep in mind that I haven't used Cherry MX Blue keys for quite a while, and this is one of the few typing experience on this keyboard. So let's see how well it goes. All right, let's see. 97 words per minute with 99% accuracy. I would say it's a very good, typing experience without having been using this keyboard for a while. And again, back to what I said, the Cherry MX Blue keys are just typist's heaven, okay? I always try to do the typing test with my Cherry MX Brown key, and the fastest I can ever go is around 94 minutes, words per minute. And that's from using that keyboard every single day. This blue keyboard, MX Blue keyboard, I haven't even used it much. Like today is the first day I'm using it, and I'm already got 97 words per minute. And you guys can also hear the clicking sound. If you're annoyed by this sound, do not buy this keyboard, because it only gets, worse the more you hear about it. But if you're fine with clicky noise, I think you're gonna be really in love with the Logitech K845 Cherry MX Blue Key keyboard. Again, with extremely useful LED lights, fully the Cherry MX compatible keycaps layout, as well as some really useful functions like the calculator and very easily reachable volume controls. It's a very well designed keyboard, okay? So more so, in my opinion, than the desk keyboard that I have as my main daily drive. So if you guys are thinking about getting this keyboard, don't hesitate. If you love typing, and if you cannot handle noise, I would suggest look elsewhere. And my advice would be go buy a CD108 full-size 10 key full-size keyboard that features the Cherry MX Brown keys, or even the Cherry MX Red keys that's silent and great for gaming and kind of good for typing. Those keyboards cost around $80. And again, as I mentioned, this keyboard, very affordable, is on sale for less than $60. So there you have it. Questions, comments, feel free to ask me in the comment section down below. I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, please do hit the like button or subscribe to my channel. I should have in the future more keyboards reviews for you guys. Okay, so thanks again, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Take care.